Hello and welcome back. This video is the follow-up for my previous video on how to get systemd bootloader to prompt for OS selection. In this video, I'll go over how to fix your dual boot for UEFI systems in case you wiped your existing or created another EFI partition. Let's get started. In this example, you can see I have Windows installed with its three partitions, but when I select the existing Windows EFI partition, it gives me a warning sign. EFI partition is too small, as 500 MB is the minimum required for Pop OS. So to mimic your scenario, I'll wipe this EFI partition, create another one for Pop OS to use, then select my root partition and go ahead with the install. Now I know the order of these partitions won't be in the recommended order, but it doesn't matter much. If you're willing enough, you could shift your whole Windows C drive to make space for the new EFI, so pick your poison. I'll just quickly speed through the install process. Pop OS is installed and ready. Now we need to boot from a Windows install media to add Windows boot files to the new EFI partition. Once booted with Windows install media, press Shift F10 to open a command prompt window, run disk part, type list disk. Select the disk where your Windows install is located. In my case, I'll type select disk 0. Now type list vol. Your new EFI partition will be the FAT32 volume you created, at least 500 MB in size. Note the volume number. Type select volume, your volume number. We have to assign any free letter to this volume. I'm using S for this example. Type assign letter equal to any vacant drive letter. Now type exit. While at it, identify the drive letter being used for your Windows NTFS data partition. Now run BCD boot as shown on screen while changing the drive letters as per your system. The first drive letter is of your Windows data partition and the second drive letter is the one you assigned to the EFI partition. This will copy Windows boot files to the EFI partition. Type exit. Hopefully you didn't get any errors in these steps. One last step remains. Boot into your Pop OS installation, open a terminal. Type sudo space hyphen I. Enter your password. Type cd space slash boot slash EFI slash loader. Type ls. You will see a loader.config file. We have to edit this. Run nano loader.config. In a new line, type timeout space 5. Where 5 is the amount of time in seconds, the boot menu is displayed. Press Ctrl S to save and Ctrl X to exit. And we are good to go. If you haven't already, you should check out my previous video where you'll be able to get this systemd boot menu. That's it for this video. Comment down your thoughts and any questions you might have. If this video helped you out, a like would be greatly appreciated. Thanks for watching.